I'm a big fan of horror, both in movies and in video games. After seeing footage of Silent Hill, Shattered Memories, it piqued my interest. I got it for my birthday and gave it a try. I hate to say this, but I was very disappointed. The game is a reimagining of the first game way back on the first PlayStation. You know, the game that followed Harry Mason after crashing his car to avoid a pedestrian. He loses consciousness to see that his daughter Cheryl is missing from the car. He then goes into the spooky town of Silent Hill, hoping to find Cheryl. Well, as you could probably imagine, Shattered Memories has the same story. I'll just say it right off the bat. I didn't like this game. One really big disappointment is the fact there's only one monster in the entire game. Yes, you heard that correctly. I encountered one monster throughout the whole game. They looked like aliens, and they were extremely annoying. You can only encounter them when you're in a nightmare, which is another disappointment. What happens is your environment totally freezes up and then the monsters appear. They're persistent and fast. You could practically never outrun them, but you can find places to hide in for a short period of time. What do I mean by that? If you're hiding for too long, they'll find you and pull you out of your hiding spot and then finish you off. When I first read that you'd have to hide from the monsters instead of fighting them, I instantly pictured a Clock Tower-like situation. In that game, being chased by Scissor Man was fun and nerve-wracking, and this game is just irritating and you want it over with as soon as possible. Now, in order to end the nightmare, you have to get to the waypoint as indicated by a blue mark on your map, which is found on your cell phone. And speaking of the cell phone, two very useful tools are your flashlight and, of course, your cell phone. Flashlight's obviously useful for, you know, being able to see in the dark, but the cell phone is very useful. You can call contacts and take pictures. You can also receive messages that give you hints on what you need to do to solve puzzles and such. Always listen to the message you get on your cell phone. It's very important to solving the latest puzzle. If you go into this game expecting the thrill, fright, and mystery that is the Silent Hill experience like I did, you're probably going to be pretty disappointed. This game is Silent Hill only in title and its characters. This game simply just does not feel like a Silent Hill game. I recently tweeted this and I still think this. Shattered Memories is basically Silent Hill for kids. It's not an awful game, but because it's a Silent Hill game, I think it had a lot of potential to live up to. And to me, it just did not live up to the potential that is the Silent Hill franchise. The game doesn't get really good until near the end, which also sucks. I do give it credit though. The story does get interesting, but it gets interesting rather late into the game, so you don't really have time to enjoy the story. I mean, it doesn't get as interesting as, say, Heavy Rain, but it still gets pretty interesting. I rate this game a 5 out of 10. It was extremely disappointing. Now, I don't know if it makes any difference, but I got the PS2 version simply because I hate the Wii. But I doubt the game is a totally different experience depending on which console you play it on. Well, thanks for watching, everybody. On that note, I just wanted to quickly remind everybody that you can find me on MySpace and Twitter at the addresses on your screen. I tweet more often than I'm on MySpace, but I'm still on both websites very frequently. Thanks, and take care.